Hi everyone, today I'll continue my topic, that is post encore, the third session. I'll start with post designs in prefabricated post. This is exclusively for prefabricated post because posts are mainly divided into custom made and prefabricated. The custom made post are customizing for the impression what you give. You will make a post piece, you will make impression of it, that impression you will send it to lab. So the lab people will make a post according to the impression what you provide. So that is about custom made post. There is not much design specifications in custom made post. So this slide is exclusively for prefabricated post. In prefabricated post, there are so many varieties, so many designs, which mainly divided into three. So these are decided by the manufacturers. Various designs are designed by various manufacturers. So those designs are mainly fall under three categories. They are parallel, tapered, and a combination of both. So in this slide, I'll talk about the advantages and disadvantages of these categories. So let's go to the parallel. The parallel post, as you all know, it will have a parallel symmetry, like the coronal section and the apical part will be having a same diameter, will be parallel. So that disadvantage, let me talk about the disadvantage. As you all know, the configuration of a root or root apex, root area will be converging towards the apex. The coronal portion will be having a greater diameter and the apex portion will have a smaller diameter. But if you want to give a post which is parallel, you have to remove the same amount of tooth structure from coronal area as well as the apex. That means you will be forced to remove excess radicular tooth structure from the apex area. That will weaken the apex of the root. It can cause root fracture. So that is the disadvantage of providing parallel post. But one main advantage it got, that is it produced a uniform stress distribution all over the post. Because the post is having same diameter at the coronal area as well as on the apical area, the stresses distributed from the post to the post space or the radicular portion of root will be uniform, which is a desirable property of this kind of post. So that is about parallel post. I have mentioned the advantages as well as the disadvantages. Now let's go to the tapered one. As you all know, the tapered configuration, that is coronally the diameter will be more and towards the apex it will be converging, the diameter will be less. It conforms to the natural tooth form, how the natural tooth root are. Coronally it will be wider and when it goes to the apex it will be narrower. So if you want to place this kind of post, then the removal of root structure from the apex will be lesser when you compare with the parallel one. So the disadvantage of parallel one, that is excessive amount of tooth structure removal from the apex, can be eliminated by giving tapered post because the size of post is narrower at the apex, so you don't need to remove excess radicular structure when you planning to place tapered post. So that disadvantage is been eliminated, but the stress distribution will not be uniform in cases of tapered post due to its shape. So I have mentioned advantages and disadvantages of these both categories. Taking the advantages from each, from parallel as well as tapered, some people have manufactured the combination of both. It is having the advantages of parallel as well as tapered. In this, the body of post will be parallel and the root apex area will be tapered. So you don't need to remove excess radicular structure from the apex in order to accommodate a combination of parallel and tapered post, because the apex will be tapered and the stress distribution will be almost uniform as the body of the post is parallel. So they have taken the two advantages from two categories and they made one mixed category, that is having more advantages, that is being more advantages than the previous mentioned categories. Now coming to material compatibility. It is ideal to make the post and core with same material, because when you use dissimilar metals, there are chances for galvanic corrosion. Galvanic corrosion, I hope all of you are familiar with in endo. Most number of root fracture cases occurs due to this galvanic corrosion because of dissimilar metals used in post as well as core. Due to galvanic corrosion, there will be evolution of corrosion products inside the post cavity, that is post space. This leads to increase in pressure. This area will be filled with corrosion products and this will lead to splitting or fracture of the root area. So this is what happens when dissimilar metals come in contact. The most corrosion resistant metal is titanium. So it is always advisable to make post and core with titanium to avoid this complication. Now coming to retrievability of post. As you all know, retrievability is one of the major criteria, desired property of post and core. But if you give a post which is metal, it's kind of impossible to retrieve, because when you try to retrieve a metal post, it may end up in root fracture or extraction of that particular tooth area. So when you try to retrieve a fiber post, that is kind of possible. Even I have tried it and I have succeeded in that, because you can use the instrument that to create a post space, that is gauge Glidden burrs and piezo rimmers. You can just use those instrument which will crush the fiber post and it will take it out. But you cannot apply this same principle with metal post, because these instruments will not be capable to crush that metal and take it out. That's not possible with those instruments. So, and it's not easy to take it out from the post base, because adhesives which we use for luting cements will be strongly adhered to the tooth. So if you try to pull a metal post from post base, it will end up in extraction of that particular tooth. So that is about retrievability. Then aesthetics. Some people are more concerned about their aesthetics. So in such cases, you should use aesthetic post materials, fiber post, ceramic post, then zirconia post, etc. Zirconia posts are the advanced post materials which are higher in aesthetics and strength. So it is advisable to use a zirconia post if your prime concern is aesthetics. Now coming to terminology called hydrostatic pressure. What is the role of hydrostatic pressure in post cementation? it is always have a role in post cementation. So I'll give an example. What is hydrostatic pressure? I hope all of you are familiar with gardening pipes. The pipes which are used for gardening, they may be either of plastic or rubber or a combination. It could be made up of plastic, rubber or a combination. While gardening, if you squeeze the orifice of that particular pipe, what will happen? If you squeeze or compress the orifice, the pressure inside, pressure of water inside that particular pipe will increase, and the distance traveled by the water from the pipe will also increase. As the pressure inside the pipe increase, the distance traveled by the water from the orifice also will increase. So that is due to increase in hydrostatic pressure, because you have constrained the orifice of the pipe. So I hope all of you understood the meaning of hydrostatic pressure, how you can increase hydrostatic pressure, what happens due to that. So similar scenario is happening during post cementation, because there is a post base which will be filled with viscous luting cement. You will apply some amount of luting cement before cementation of post to the post base with the help of any instrument, smaller instrument, narrower instrument. After that, you will apply some amount of cement to the post also. After applying this, you will try to insert the post into the post base. When you do that, there is already some amount of cement, viscous cement inside the post base, and there is more cement over the post. So when you try to insert, the hydrostatic pressure increases. This hydrostatic pressure can later develop radicular fractures. So in order to avoid that, you are supposed to, this is a custom made post, you are supposed to make vertical grooves. This is a vertical groove. I think all of you can appreciate a vertical groove throughout the post. Throughout the post, from here till here. So if you are placing or fixing a post, usually you can do it on a custom made post, not on prefabricated post, because it may break. If it's a metal post, yeah, you can try for that. If you do a cementation of custom made post with vertical groove on it, when you try to insert this portion into the post base, definitely hydrostatic pressure will rise, because the volume of cement will increase and you are applying some amount of pressure upon that. So as the volume of viscous cement increases, hydrostatic pressure increases. Due to that, some amount of excess cement will flow out through this channel. When you insert it, this excess cement will try to flow through this area and it will go out. It will go out from the tooth. Hence, it reduces the generation of hydrostatic pressure inside post base. Hence, it stops the radicular fracture. So that is about hydrostatic pressure, and that is the solution to avoid hydrostatic pressure. This hydrostatic pressure can even cause fracture. So it can inversely affect your treatment. So this is how, by giving a vertical groove with any instrument, can save the tooth from the generation of hydrostatic pressure. So I hope you understood this idea. Now coming to various cores. It consists of a restorative material placed on the coronal area of tooth, which replaces caries, fractured or missing coronal structure, and retains the final crown on it. These cores will be supported or anchored with the help of the previous post which is been placed over it, under it, not over it. So the amount of post will be protruding towards the coronal area over which the cores are seated. And there are so many core material available in the market. So accordingly, we will anchor the core to the tooth structure and over which we will give a crown. These are various types of cores available. They are cast metal cores, amalgam cores, composite resin cores, glass ionomer cores, resin glass ionomer, it's a combination, then titanium core materials. Now I'll try to explain each one in detail. Now let's go to the cast metal core. So about this I have explained in the first slide. When a patient comes to your clinic with a fractured tooth, fractured endodontic tooth, what you can do. In that case, I have showed how to give a cast metal post and core. So that is applicable here also. The cast metal post and core are most strong post and core which is available nowadays. They are most strong material. That is their advantage. They have a disadvantage, which I already mentioned in previous slides, because they are fabricated in a laboratory by indirect methods. They are fabricated in a laboratory by indirect methods. They are not directly making or fixing in patient's mouth. You have to get the cast post and core from the laboratory. When patients comes to you, you are supposed to create a post base, then you will make an impression of it. That particular impression you will send to the lab. So your first appointment is over. When patients comes to you with a fractured tooth, you will make the post base, you will make impression, you will send the patient. So that is the disadvantage of cast metal post. Because patient will not be satisfied in patient's first appointment. You are making the patient to come to visit again, at least to get a temporary crown. So if your patient is more aesthetically concerned, you can't satisfy that patient by giving a cast post and core, because you have to recall the patient 2 or 3 days afterwards when you receive the post and core metal cast post and core from the laboratory. You have to recall the patient in order to fix it in patient's teeth, and then only you can think about giving a temporary. So that period is a problem with cast post and core. So you have to convince the patient by giving them the advantages and disadvantages, and you should make the patient to choose whether to go for cast post and core or whether to go for prefabricated one. You should tell the patient, giving them the examples or giving them advantages and disadvantages. You should make the patient to choose which one to go for. So that is about the advantages and disadvantages. And it is obviously more expensive because you are involving a lab just to give one post. And if you are going for a prefabricated one, you don't need to consult a lab for that, because you can choose a desirable post from the market and you can cement it. That's all. You don't need to send any work to anywhere. And it's quick also, prefabricated one. Then it requires multiple appointments. As I mentioned earlier, you have to call patient once again. One more appointment is needed if you choose cast metal post than prefabricated one. Risk of casting inaccuracy. If there is any casting inaccuracy, when you call the patient for the second appointment for posterior encore fixation, if there is any casting inaccuracy, the posterior encore, what you have in your hand will not fix or will not fitted onto the particular post piece. Then you have to repeat the impression and you have to send back the patient for one more appointment. So that is the problem with custom-made posterior encore. Now let's talk about amalgam cores. Faceting high copper alloy is used for amalgam cores. As you all know, amalgam lacks in chemical retention. Amalgam doesn't have any chemical retention. It always have mechanical retention. So you have to provide some mechanical factors to improve its retention. Otherwise, it will dislodge from the post piece. So that is the problem with amalgam cores. But it is having so many advantages. It is having high compressive strength. Amalgam is a material which is having so many higher qualities as well as so many lower qualities. So advantages are, it is having high compressive strength, it is having high tensile strength, it will be stable under functional stresses. Hence you can use this amalgam core in cases where more masticating forces can be generated, in cases where molars teeth, because it will be stable under functional stresses. And now let's go to the disadvantages. It is having tendency for corrosion. If you are using a metal post and given amalgam core over it, the chances of corrosion is more, galvanic corrosion. So it can cause root fracture or discoloration of gingiva or dentin. So this is what happens. And when you go for amalgam core, you have to use retentive pins, which I will discuss later. You have to use some 3 or 4 retentive pins in order to aid retention for amalgam cores to the tooth. So that is another criteria for giving amalgam cores. Now let's talk about composite resin cores. Composite resins are most commonly used material for restoration purpose. Then how it will act as a core material, that's what I'm going to discuss here. It is very easy to manipulate and it sets very rapidly because most of the composite resins are light cured. So the setting is very rapid. You don't have to wait at all. You just place it and you can use the light source in order to set the composite resin. That is the most advantageous material in this category, but it is having so many disadvantages which I will mention here. As you all know, polymerization shrinkage or contraction of the material after polymerization is more for composite resin. This can lead to micro leakage, which is higher than amalgam, GIC, or a combination of GIC and resin. So it is having, when you place the core material over the coronal section of the tooth and you make it set by giving a light source. After setting, there are chances of polymerization shrinkage and it shrinks. When it shrinks, there will be a small gap between the coronal structure and the composite resin core. Through this gap, if there is a micro leakage, it can lead to leakage of materials like blood, saliva, etc., debris or microorganisms also. This can lead to secondary caries. So that is the main disadvantages of composite resin core. Now coming to glass ionoma core. It is high viscosity GIC can be used in case of glass ionoma cores. As you all know, GIC having an anti-cariogenic property by fluoride release. So that is advantageous than any other materials. It is having ionic bond, that is chemical bond. So GIC can be chemically and mechanically attached to the tooth structure. That is another advantage. Micro leakage from GIC is comparatively very lesser when you compare with composite resin. Now we'll go for the disadvantages. It is soluble and sensitive to moisture. If there is any micro leakage through marginal leakage, not micro leakage, if there is any marginal leakage by faulty adapted crowns, there are chances of saliva seepage through this marginal inaccuracies of the crown to inside postern core. So that time, if there is presence of moisture on this glass ionomer core, it is soluble and it is sensitive to moisture. The properties may change. And fracture toughness is lesser. That means it is kind of brittle when you compare with other materials. Hence, it cannot be used in anterior teeth region, or it cannot replace a cusp which is unsupported. Because if in future, if forces acting on that particular unsupported cusp, as the material is brittle, it can break easily. So that is the main disadvantage of glass ionomer core. Now let's talk about amalgam pin retained core restorations. As I told, amalgam doesn't have any chemical bond with the tooth structure. So you have to improve or increase the amount of mechanical retention features. That is, we have to use pins. As you all can see in this picture, you are not supposed to give pins on the proximal surfaces or over the furcation areas. You are not supposed to give these areas. You have to give pins in the line angles. Mainly 3 or 4 line angles will be there. In molars there will be 4. Those line angles can be used in order to anchor a pin to support the overlying amalgam core. So these pins are necessary when you are planning for amalgam core. Amalgam is having so many advantages and some disadvantages. One of the disadvantages is it is not having any chemical bond. So in order to overcome that, you are supposed to give pins to improve its mechanical bonding property. So pins were described for anchoring amalgam in teeth with extensive coronal damage. It will not reinforce this amalgam. It will just improve its retentive capacity. That's all. If you increase the number of pins, it will reduce the strength of amalgam. The amalgam itself can break if you increase the number of pins. You are not supposed to increase the number of pins from 3 to 4, not more than that, because it will reduce the strength property of amalgam and it may lead to breakage of amalgam core. It is placed to aid in the retention of core and not to strengthen the amalgam core. You should keep this in mind. You are not supposed to give more than 4 pins. If you give so, it will weaken the tooth as well as the amalgam core. So 3 to 4 pins are okay in these areas, only on the line angles, not on any other areas. So that's all about today's lecture. If you have any doubts, please contact me. In the next class, I will explain about the different procedures in postern core, how you can give a postern core, different procedures from the beginning to the end. Thank you.